because of our experience with them, they didn't treat us well. So therefore, we saw the Biafran people as a minority in Nigeria. But we did know about the oppression and so forth. Some British journalists, particularly, he became the famous journalist later, Frederick Forsyth, great writer, based some of his Dogs of War, his books on mercenaries and famine and oppression. He based it very much on his experience in Nigeria in the 1960s, particularly during the Biafran war. But we were very conscious of the terrible sufferings of the Biafran people and very conscious of the terrible famine and what happened to you.
Yes, thank you very much. You know, as you know today, the hand of the British is still operating in Nigeria as a result of their economic interest. And the problem we have majorly is that when the British left the pretense that Nigeria had given Nigeria independence, they kind of, the colonization to the minority Fulani tribe. And they were able to use the Fulani to operate from inside while the British makes the gains from the outside. So I don't know your viewpoint on this issue of using the Fulani oligarchy, because I can tell you that there are lots of Fulani suffering. There are poor Fulanis on the street who cannot feed. But the Fulani oligarchy, you know, have become the tool in the hand of the British government to manipulate the system. And today we have killings by the Fulani herdsmen, unquestionable killings. So I don't know what you have to tell the Biafran people, your advice on the way forward.
When you mentioned the British being involved, a brilliant British tactic always was divide and conquer. You can talk about Kenya, you can talk about India, you can talk about anywhere. So that therefore it would have suited the British for the Fulani and for the northern Nigerians to be fighting with the southern and Biafran, you know, and the Igbo people. Because the British, with a small number of colonial masters, were able to conquer whole peoples, partly by using local people. And we use the expression in Ireland, divide and conquer. The British were the masters of that.
You see, British have this specific style of operation by dividing and ruling and conquering people. And that is what we have today. As you know, in the eastern part of Nigeria, there's a very great division. With the geographical map, you know, the entire eastern region has been balkanized by the British by using the Fulanis, creating what you call the south and the southeast and the Niger Delta, giving different kind of name, you know, to confuse the people. So we have some of the people from the south, and you know, can you please tell us, is there any geographical location that is called south-south? Is there any geographical location in geography? Is there anything called south-south in geography?
Oh, no.
You go ahead. Go ahead.
No. But I understand what you're saying. Obviously, I wouldn't have all the detail exactly of Nigeria. Ironically, the one thing I did know was the Civil War and Ajuku and Gowan and so forth. Mainly, as I said earlier, through the efforts of the Irish who were on the ground there and who gave us a different picture than what BBC was giving us. These guys came home. Many of them, as I said, were expelled by the federal authorities. But somehow your story lived on because we could identify, we were a small people who were oppressed too. And we knew that. We particularly knew the British. So when we heard they were there, enough.
Thank you very much. This is Ignatius. Irish, are you a tourist in Rome?
Tourist, yes.
Yeah, he's in Rome of the tourism, and in the process of the tour, he met the Biafra people, and he was able to identify immediately the name Biafra. You know, so anybody who is telling you that Biafra does not exist, and they are trying to sweep us under the carpet, but in this generation, we are determined to make Biafra a reality. So what is your parting shot for Biafra's
government? Small people, one thing that dictators cannot control is social media.
Yes.
Get your message out there. People are watching you around the world now.
Yes, thank you very much, Ignatius. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Oh, we can see that Ignatius have told us everything. need to know about that. He told us that he's not a good person.